Naming alkenes. Alkenes have a carbon-carbon double bond as their functional group. The IUPAC name of alkenes ends in ene, the same as the family name. There are two other differences between naming alkanes and alkenes. With alkenes, the longest chain selected must contain the carbon-carbon double bond. There might be longer chains, but the base word has to be the chain that contains that carbon-carbon double bond. And then when we number the longest chain, we want to get the lowest number for the positions of the carbons involved in the double bond. Let's look at an example. I've shown just the carbon skeleton so that it's a little easier to see the position of the double bond. There are five carbons up here. So pent would be the base part of the base word. Then it would have that ene ending because of the presence of the double bond, pentene. There are always two ways you can number a chain. If I numbered from the left, 1, 2, 3, the carbon-carbon double bond would be between 3 and 4, and we'd come up with the name 3-pentene. But if I number from the right, 1, 2, the carbon-carbon double bond is between positions 2 and 3. Or another way of saying that is that we want a number from the end that's closest to the carbon-carbon double bond. And we use only one number to indicate the position of the double bond, the first number. So this is 2-pentene and not 3-pentene. Here's another example. This one has a couple of chains. We could have a chain like this, or like this, or like this. But you want to be certain to pick out a chain that the longest chain that contains the carbon-carbon double bond. And I've numbered it here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The base word would be hexene. We'd number from the end closest to the carbon-carbon double bond. So the double bond is between positions 2 and 3. It would be a 2-hexene. And then finally, we'd want to add to this any carbons that were not included as a part of the longest chain. And here we have two of those carbons at position 3. This would be an ethyl group, so and it's located at position 3. The full name then would be 3-ethyl-2-hexene. And again, I would recommend that you, when you name an organic compound using the IUPAC system, that you take the rules stepwise, because any error that you might make is a violation of one of the rules. So rather than starting at the end, start up here with rule number one and proceed logically. Let's look at a cyclic structure. When a double bond is located within a ring, we always want the two carbons involved in the double bond to be at positions 1 and 2. That fixes the numbering system. So at position 3, we've got a group attached. And let's just take the rules one step at a time, though. The base word, it's derived from cyclopentane. We change the ending to ene, cyclopentene. And then the position of the double bond is at 1. And because within a ring it has to be at 1, a lot of times we just omit that number 1 and we'd call it cyclopentene. And at position 3, we have a 3-carbon group. It's a propyl, 3-propyl cyclopentene. It's possible to have more than one double bond within a structure. Let's look at one of those. This structure has two carbon-carbon double bonds. We'd want to make sure that the longest chain that we select as the base word includes both of those positions. And here I've numbered the carbons 1 through 5. When two double bonds are present, it's referred to as a diene. If I had 3 double bonds, it would be a triene, and so on. So this is a pentadiene that we've selected as the longest chain. We'd number it down here so that we have double bonds at positions 1 and 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. If I had numbered it the other way, 1, 2, 3, 4, we would have gotten a little higher number for this group that's attached out there. So the correct name is 2-isopropyl-1,4-pentadiene.